فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافاتي وتنهل من ربى الخير.
Similarly, nowadays while we are during the blessed month of Rajab, Rajab is one of the four sacred months, which is Muharram, Rajab, Dhul Qa'dah, and Dhul Hijjah. That is mentioned in the Quran, مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمْ فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. And these sacred months are superior to the rest of the months with regards to the sacredness of the time. We're supposed to avoid sins, we're supposed to increase doing the good deeds. But specifying a particular good deed on a particular time requires a reference or an evidence. I'm referring to when people plan to perform Umrah during the month of Rajab for a specific reason. It is better than any other time, or it has a greater reward. There is no such thing. The time in which it was specified that if you perform Umrah, it will be as great as performing Hajj, even with the Prophet ﷺ, is during Ramadan. فَإِنَّ عُمْرَةً فِي رَمَضَانَ تَعْدِلُ حَجَّةً مَعِي. That is not for any other time. Second, fasting on a specific date or day, it requires a reference. We know that the Prophet ﷺ used to fast on Mondays and Thursdays, and he recommended fasting on the three white days, 13th, 14th, and 15th. And I reminded you last week with that. And alhamdulillah wa shukrillah, many of us observe fasting Thursday, on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, because it was 13th, 14th, and 15th of the month of Rajab. When somebody says that we should be fasting on the 27th because it is the miracle of Al-Isra and Al-Mi'raj and so on, I have to present the following fact. Number one, it is not proven that the miracle of the journey of Al-Mi'raj took place on the 27th of Rajab. So where did you come up with this date? It's mentioned in some books, but they always say that it is not confirmed. So we have to be careful with that. Who was the one who is blessed with the journey of Al-Isra, traveling at night in a part of the night from Mecca to Bayt al-Maqdis, and led the prayer with all the prophets? That's Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the journey extended to continue to ascending to heaven. That was Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Afterward, he never celebrated that date, nor any of his companions. If any person believes that he is smarter than the Prophet or more righteous than the companions, because some people say, well, because the Prophet was the most pious, he never celebrated his own birthday, he never celebrated the birthday of his children because he was humble. This reasoning very common. They say, but if we truly love the Prophet ﷺ, we should honor him and honor everything he used to do. But this is not true. This is not what you've been doing. If you have been doing the right thing or what you're preaching, then you would stick to what he ordered us to do. Then afterward, if you finish all the sunan, we can talk about it. But these guys, they barely practice the fard, and the sunnah has no room in their life. But they jump to invent things because that's called easy religion. Easy deen. They do what they like, whenever they like. On the 10th of Muharram, they cook the sweet and they call it Ashura. So we enjoy eating and drinking. In some cultures, during these occasions, if a couple are engaged, the fiancé has to buy for his fiancé a gold gift, a ring or an earring or a necklace or whatever. The whole family is waiting for this time. And that's why they consider, they adhere to these traditions as if it is a fard. And some families break the relationship, the engagement, if the future groom does not fulfill that. They think this is a deen. It has nothing to do with the deen. There is no such celebration on these occasions. On the 10th of Muharram, Ashura, the Prophet ﷺ fasted, and he recommended fasting, and he said it wipes the sins of the past year for those who fast on that day, because Allah saved Musa ﷺ and his followers. In Rajab, it's a sacred month. We should do good deeds as much as we can. And those who are regularly observing fasting on Mondays and Thursdays, continue doing so. If coincidentally you're traveling to perform Umrah, thank you so much, may Allah bless you. But there is nothing called a particular Umrah during Rajab, during Sha'ban, or we have to fast on the day of the 27th. And at night, my God, many communities, they make a big deal on that night and celebrations, and particular food has to be cooked, and they recite poetry and have nothing to do with the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. I know that it might not please many people what they hear right now, but this is a fact. The Prophet ﷺ said, follow and do not innovate. اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا. You see the difference between the two vocabulary? اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا. Follow and do not innovate. Even if you think this is cool, this is great, this is righteous, but the Prophet ﷺ neither did it nor recommended us to do it, then it will be rejected. مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدْ. Go ahead and search all the records of the Sunnah. If you can fetch any proof that says that it is recommended or even permissible to celebrate that occasion, bring it on. Perhaps we can join you. But if you fail, don't you dare to say, but my sheikh said so. Because your sheikh and my sheikh and every sheikh is supposed to follow the greatest sheikh, the greatest messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I have some people who say that, but I have seen in a dream the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you got to do this. In vain. Invalid. Doesn't work. Because if you have seen a dream, I also saw dreams. And everybody can come up with a dream or a ru'ya. Do you think that we can make a new religion based on dreams? اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I have completed for you your religion and perfected my favor upon you, and I'm pleased with Islam as your religion. It was revealed during the farewell Hajj, and this is it. You cannot add anything to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if it is in a form of celebration based on mere thinking that it may be good. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. I hope that we benefit from this. Every year and every occasion, we try to propagate the proper understanding, the proper deen. But it's up to you to follow or to innovate.